In previous lessons, we've talked about what it means to be a solution to a linear equation. In this lesson, we're going to talk about what it means to be a solution to something called a system. System of linear equations. Now, that is really nothing more than a collection of linear equations. For example, a system of linear equations could be 2x plus 3y equals 6 and 4x minus 7y equals 10. Every point that is on this line is a solution to this line. Every point that is on this line is a solution to this line. What we're going to study in this next unit is what is the common solution, if indeed it exists. Let me show you the three different scenarios that could happen. We could have one line coming in like this, and maybe another one looking like this. And I'm sorry, those are not perfectly straight lines. Every point on this line is a solution to the equation defining it. Every point on this line is a solution to the equation defining it. But this point right here is a common solution. It is a solution to both of them, and that's what we're going to be finding in this unit. Sometimes the scenario looks like this, and we will be looking for this common shared point of intersection. There are some other scenarios that could occur. There is the possibility that this is one of the linear equations, and the other linear equation is parallel to it. Now, every point on this line is a solution to its equation. Every point on this line is a solution to its equation. They share no points. There is no intersection. This system has no solution. Finally, there is a third scenario where you graph or look at all the solutions to a linear equation. And then when you look at all the solutions to the other linear equation, you find out that they actually are the same. Those are what we call coincidental lines. They are the same line. When that happens, these two equations share an infinite number of solutions. So this has infinite solutions. So when we talk about the solution to a system or a group of equations, we might have a single solution, we might have no solution, we might have infinite solutions. Now, as we move through the sections in this unit, we're going to find different methods for finding out what the solutions are. In this lesson, we're simply going to test proposed answers to see if they are indeed solutions. So let's take a look at a few. The first one, it says determine whether each ordered pair is a solution. All right, my system is x plus y equals 7 and 2x plus 5y equals 23. The first point that you're asked to test is the point 4, 3. To see if the point 4, 3 is a solution to the equation, I will plug in 4 for x and 3 for y, and I will simply see if it is a true statement or a false statement. And obviously 4 plus 3 is 7, so this is true. The point 4, 3 is a solution to this equation of the system. Now let's see if it's also a solution to this one. I'm checking to see is 2 times 4 plus 5 times 3 equal to 23. Well, that gives me 8 That gives me 15. And sure enough, that sum is 23, is equal to 23. So that's true. The point 43 is a solution to this equation. 43 is a solution to both, so the answer is yes. We go on to see if the point 16 is a solution. Well, I start back over. X plus y is 7. Is 1 for x plus 6 for y equal to 7? The answer is yes, that's true. It is a solution to that equation. So now we look at 2x plus 5y is equal to 23. So 2 times 1 plus 5 times 6, is that equal to 23? Well, 2 times 1 is 2. 5 times 6 is 30. Is 2 plus 30 equal to 23? Well, no, that's a false statement. The point in question, in this case 16, has to make both of them true in order to be a solution. So the answer is no, it is not a solution. The only way a point can be a solution is that it must be a solution to both of them. All right, let's look at this one. I have negative 5x plus 2y is negative 13 is one of them, and negative 2x plus 9y is 3. I really have three problems here. I need to test negative 6, negative 1. I need to test 1, negative 4, and I need to test 3, 1. All right, so I have negative 5 times negative 6 plus 2 times negative 1. Is that negative 13? Well, that's, oh, I'm so sorry. Once again, I'm touching things. That's 30 plus negative 2. Is that negative 13? No, that's false. I don't really even have to test this to see if negative 2 times negative 6 plus 9 times negative 1 is 3, because if it didn't test here, I don't really care if it tests here. This cannot be a solution. So then I go on. Is negative 5 times 1, because I'm testing 1, negative 4, plus 2 times negative 4 equal to negative 13? That's negative 5 plus negative 8. Is that negative 13? And yes, it is. So it was a solution to the first one. Let's test the second one. I have negative 2 times 1 plus 9 times negative 4. Is that 3? So I have negative 2 plus negative 36. Is that 3? No, that's false. B is not a solution. Finally, let's see, is negative 5 times, I'm going to test 3 for x and 1 for y. Negative 5 times 3 plus 2 times 1, is that negative 13? Well, that's negative 15 plus 2, is that negative 13? Yes, it is. I just put a T for true. Now I'll test, is negative 2 times 3 plus 2 times, I'm sorry, wrong number, 9 times 1 equal to 3. That's negative 6 plus 9. Is that 3? Yes, it is 3. True, true. It is a solution to both. So the answer is C. So there's just a good bit of checking with these. We have one more. I have 3y is equal to 6x plus 15, and I have 2x minus y is equal to negative 5. First, I'm supposed to test negative 3, negative 1. 3 times the y value of negative 1, is that equal to 6 times negative 3 plus 15? Well, simplifying the left side, that's negative 3. This side, that's negative 18 plus 15, and I can tell right now that's a true statement. because this is negative 3. So it tested true in that point, in that equation. Let's test it over here. 2 times negative 3, which is the x, minus parentheses negative 1, is that negative 5. All right, that's negative 6 minus minus means plus. Plus 1, or negative 5. Is negative 6 plus 1, well, that's negative 5, equals negative 5. That's true. So the answer to the first part is yes, that's a solution to the system. Now I have 3 times the y value of negative 5. Is that equal to 6 times 0 plus 15? That's negative 15 is equal to, that's gone, 15. That's false. If it's false in one of them, I really don't care about the other one because it cannot possibly be a solution. So to be a solution, you have to be a solution to both equations of a system.